Hi, this is the Cool Geek, and in the past video we have seen how to remove duplicates when you have a categorical column and a transactional column and find the maximum and minimum of a particular transactional column, right? Now we have used one particular column to get the maximum and minimum of units sold in the previous video, but in this video what we're going to do is how do we get the minimum and maximum of units sold. So if you have two particular categories, how do you get the maximum and minimum? So in this example, we're going to cover how we're going to get the maximum and minimum of units sold when you have two categorical columns. The procedure is going to remain the same. You're going to sort and then remove duplicates, but we are going to do a two level sorting and then remove the duplicates on two columns, right? To do this, select this data, say sort at two, three levels. First is going to be product sold. Second is going to be sales channel. Third is going to be units sold, as you, all the three that we have here. And I'm going to leave the unit sold order by smallest to largest, since you're targeting to get the minimum value, right? Say okay. And I'll say remove duplicates, uncheck unit sold, and say okay. Right, so you have 36 unique values that are there, and we have the minimum unit sold in each of the products by the various channels. So this is how we get the minimum of units sold for each of these categories. Now I'm going to do the same thing for maximum. Procedure is going to remain the same. I'm going to select this data, say sort at three levels, product sold, sales channel, and units sold. The only difference is we're going to say largest to smallest, that is sorted by descending order. Say okay, remove duplicates, uncheck units sold, and say okay. Right, so again 36 values, and you have the maximum and minimum for both of these categories, right? Now you can keep on adding the categorical variables and then get the maximum and minimum of a transactional column, but please note that you cannot do the same thing when you have two or more transactional column, right? So you will have to target any one particular transactional column, but the number of categorical columns can increase however you want. This is very similar to the pivot tables on how you get the maximum and minimum, but obviously in pivot tables you can do much more than one transaction column. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button below, and please don't forget to subscribe to this channel.